Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today it's actually a holiday in Isla Paraíso and Jim has the day off. He usually works on Sunday, but today he can actually enjoy the holiday. Before I pressed the recording button, Jim got an invitation for a party from someone who was very mean to Jim in the last part, so he will not go to that party. Instead, he will throw his own party, and guess what? It will be at the pool. Jim always wanted to throw a party. He is very social because of his charisma skill. And all that, including his work. It has been a while since I created a party event in Sims 3. In Sims 4, it's fine for me. In here, it has been a long, long time, but you have to pick a destination, which will be the pool. And that's it. I am pretty sure, since it is a holiday, there will be a lot of Sims at this location. And Jim will be able to make new friends and to get along with the ones that he actually invited for the pool party. I feel a bit sad because the only best friend that Jim has is the one that was hiding secrets from Jim and was doing all that stuff. And when Jim wanted to break things up, the Sim was very, very mean to Jim. I really hope he can eventually make a new best friend and maybe something else. We will see about that. So Jim got a notification that says Lupita Alto's party, which Jim has been invited to, starts in 1 hour. Obviously, Jim will not go to that party. He is very mad at Lupita. She was hiding a lot of stuff from him and he doesn't forget the things she did. Jim is at the pool now. This is actually the first venue that Jim went on first part. The pool looks really cool with this design and seem to have a lot of fun in there, so I think this pool party will be lit. I believe that some of Jim's guests are already here, including the lady with the scales, which, you know, it means that she is a mermaid. I thought Jim was able to buy some pizza for the party because there are no food at this venue, but as you can see, the call for service was not available from this location. I don't know if it is because it is a public location or if it is because there's an event happening, which means it's the party. Oh well, there's no food, but I hope at least they have a great time. I was still looking around to see if there was something that I could do because, as I said, I didn't play Sims 3 much back in the day, so I was thinking that maybe I was missing something. But no, it actually has to be in service, call for service, and then you can call for a pizza. From my understanding, you don't have any options available. It's not like in Sims 4 that you actually have a couple of options. So Jim will start by greeting his guests and talking to them, getting to know them a little better. Jim pretty much knows them from the beach, from his work, and he wants to know them a little better now. Jim is talking to the mermaid, and she seems to find Jim funny. It actually says that she thinks Jim is being amusing, so everything is going well for Jim, at least for now. There's actually a lot of Sims in this pool. Again, it is a public place, I guess. And some of them Jim didn't invite. I'm glad that there are all those Sims here, so Jim has a lot of people to meet. So I think the best way for Jim to do that is to keep talking to all the Sims, being funny, tell jokes, tell funny stories, because, yeah, we don't have food here in this venue, so I'm not sure about that. And Jim also got a promotion on his day off. How amazing is that? It says, "Congratulations. Jim has been conferred the new title of two words that I cannot pronounce. in English by the Isla Paradiso Town Council in recognition of his valuable contributions to the workforce. A lifeline to all swimmers in distress, weak or strong. You could drag an entire baseball team to shore if you needed to. Oh, this is very interesting because, you know, sometimes there are two, three swimmers in the water and Jim can only rescue one at a time. So I'm not sure if now he is able to rescue more than one swimmer, at least from what is said in this notification. And it also says that Jim can now wade and swim faster. I am really, really hoping this is true and now he can finally swim faster, because it has been annoying. I know I am always saying this, but I was expecting for lifeguards to be somehow faster because they have to save other swimmers. So I'm really hoping this is true and Jim can actually be faster overall. It's time for Jim to go swim for a little bit. I think Jim will love to make a big splash from the diving board, I guess. Or actually dive, we'll see about that. Everyone seems to be having a great time in the pool. Everyone, some are chilling, others are swimming, doing hold breath contests. It seems a lot of fun, actually. Jim is getting a phone call. Guess who it was? Well, it says, "We missed you at the party, Jim. Hopefully you can make it next time. Keep dreaming, Lupita." Jim is done with you. Keep dreaming, Lupita. Jim is done with you. It's finally time for Jim to go home and it says, "Jim's party was awesome, verging on epic. Sims all around town will be talking about this one for years." Well done, Jim. I'm so happy he finally was able to throw a party and it went very well. Everyone enjoyed the party, even without food. Next time we will remember the food. Jim is finally home and now I will try to see if he can order a pizza, because at that venue he was not able to, as you saw. So hopefully now he can order a pizza. So this time around you can actually call for service. The option is actually available. I'm taking a look of all the service that are available with the pension packs that I have at the moment and all that. So he placed the order and now I wasn't sure if Jim had time to go to take a shower or not, because in Sims 4 the delivery is super fast and I was thinking that in Sims 3 was also very fast, and I was so wrong about that. It took a while, so Jim ended up taking a shower and then there was some kind of glitch that Jim was having a hard time to accept the delivery. I was also trying to see if you can tip the delivery sim, but you can't. In Sims 4 you can actually tip the delivery sims. Jim is also very tired. I was hoping that the food will be here very fast so Jim would eat and go to bed, because I think he has to work tomorrow, but it was taking such a long time, it was unbelievable. Jim is so tired, but he is also hungry all at once. It looks so good. You can still see Jim's tattoo on his leg. I'm not sure if I'm able to get that tattoo removed in this part and Jim get another one, but we will see about that. Jim actually has more money now, way more money than before, actually. And I'm thinking about doing a house renovation soon. At least, you know, the wallpapers and some of the furniture, make it more bright, and changing some of the appliances, because they broke very easily, the appliance Jim has now. So we will see about that. It's a new day. Jim has to work today, so he will take care of his needs right now. One thing I am very happy about filming this part is because my computer was not overheating. There wasn't any glitches, at least for now, and so it went very smoothly. So I'm not sure what happened in the other part. As I said, Jim's house really needs a renovation and his kitchen sink is always getting broken. This time around it got broken around the time that Jim needed to go to work. So Jim is not able to repair the sink at the moment, and this will be a nightmare. Wait for it. But right now Jim really has to go to work.
Oh, Tali Rota.
When Jim took the taxi boat, I guess, I was like, oh, maybe he will go to the beach that I really want for him to work. And I was right, he was going to that beach. It's so cute, it has the surfboard, it is so bright, I don't know how to explain, but I really wanted for Jim to work in that location. I just wanted the seashells to move. It will be funny that each day they will be in a different area of that part of the beach. But I guess they are there the entire time. In the other beaches that Jim worked, you don't see the starfish and stuff like that. I really hoped that the starfish will move around a little bit. It will be very funny. While Jim was in the taxi, he got a notification that said Jim Sims is in mourning because Margarita Manzano died. He will always keep Margarita alive in his memory. So I was trying to see if it showed up in the relationships who she was, but it didn't. And when I was editing this video, I actually saw her name in the invitation list for his party, but he never invited her for his party. I think it was someone that he saved in one of his work days, I guess. There's a seashell that Jim will collect during this work day. It looks so beautiful, and I think he can use it as a decoration at his house. This location is so beautiful, but now that Jim is working here, I am a bit concerned about the rocks because they block the view, and I hope there's no one else in trouble in the other side of the rocks. Sometimes I will move the camera around to see if there's anyone in trouble there, because you can't really see much from where Jim is standing and where those rocks are. Someone needs help. It's the first rescue, and now we will see if Jim is actually faster or not. Look, Jim didn't do that in the other episodes. He's now like jumping in the waves or something, as lifeguards do in real life, so I am expecting for Jim to be really fast. He is swimming faster. Yes, he is faster now. This is so good. I am actually so happy for this. This is what I wanted all along for Jim or any lifeguard in the Sims 3. And now I am really, really happy that he is able to swim a lot faster and rescue Sims faster. Although, I'm not sure if he can rescue more than one Sim in the water, like it said in the notification. I hope so, but I'm not sure just yet. And now there are two ghosts at this location. I think they are the same that we have seen in other locations. I think they are the same that we saw in other beaches while Jim was working. I don't know what happened to these ghosts. They share the same last name, so I'm not sure if they are married, if they belong to the same family, what happened. Jim actually saved the lady from drowning again, because they are dripping water, which means that they passed by drowning. I think CSI Sofia will be here in the next part with the information about them, or at least I will try to research them, because you can tell that they drown, but I'm not sure why they keep going back to the beaches. At first I thought they passed away in Sands Park Beach, which is the beach right next to Jim's house, but now they are showing in other areas of Isla Paradiso, so I'm not sure about that, but it's interesting at the same time, or at least it is for me. And Jim doesn't like ghosts very much. much. It says, Jim seems just saw the ghost of Kara Drag. It won't be easy to forget the sight of that spooky apparition. Jim hates ghosts, I'm telling you. Jim will now collect the seashell. The ghosts are around those rocks that I was talking about. Not sure if they drowned because the lifeguard at the moment wasn't able to see them on the other side of the rocks, because it blocks the view a little bit, as I was saying. That would actually make sense, and they haunt this beach because of that. They don't learn the lesson. They can't go swim like that. Clearly, swimming is not for them, and they still continue to swim. Oh boy. Jim will also talk about beach safety with a couple of sims, just in case. I love how there are always sharks on the above their heads. And haven't seen a shark in this entire Sims 3 Let's Play, so not sure about that. But from my understanding, one of the new deaths in Sims 3 Island Paradise is dead by shark. So it is a possibility, but we haven't seen them yet. I keep checking to see if anyone is in trouble, but so far Jim only rescued one sim. And now I really want him for rescue to more sims, because he is now much faster, but at the same time, poor sims. I don't want anything bad to happen to the other sims. No loud music on Jim's watch again. Also, look who is here. She never leaves Jim alone. Jim has to rescue another sim. Let's see how fast he can go. Not sure if Jim has to give CPR to that lady. She wasn't in the water for that long, now that he is much faster. Oh no, that teenager wasn't even in the water and she passed out on the sand. I think this is something that can happen in real life. Sometimes heat waves, people get dizzy, I guess, and they pass out. And I think that's what happened to this teenager. So now Jim has to give CPR to the lady that was in the water, and he also needs to give CPR to that teen that just arrived on the beach. It looked like she has had her homework or a book. It seems like she wasn't even planning on go on the water, and now she needs help. Oh well. The lady said, "I thought I was a goner there. Thanks for saving my life." The lady is very grateful to Jim. The teen said, "I am glad there are lifeguards like you to save sims like me." She wasn't even in the water. Maybe it was the heat wave. I don't know, but glad Jim was able to help her. Jim is like, "No problem, I'm here for this." And he will talk with her about beach safety as well, even though she wasn't in the water, as I said many times by now. But it's the truth. I mean, you saw that. Jim is done with his work for today. It's time to go home. He will take the taxi again. Too many taxis in the water. And oh no, look at Jim's kitchen. What a nightmare. There's water everywhere. Jim has a lot of things to do at his home right now. He has to fix the sink and he needs to mop the floor. It looks really, really bad. I feel really, really bad for Jim. The house really looks like a mess. This is so sad. So that's it for today's episode. If you enjoyed, make sure to subscribe, like and share, and I will see you in the next part.